morning. My name is Jim Deering, distributor for BuildBlock in the Southern California region. What we're going to go over this morning is we're at the World of Concrete, and we've had a lot of questions presented to us. Why is BuildBlock the block of choice? Why is it more user-friendly than the other blocks that are out there? And what is some industry standards that I use on a daily basis with some of the California type of production framing? And taking that background that I have in production framing and actually bringing forth more of a simplified way of commonality as far as working with the corners and the standards and working with your subs and making the block come together so that it's not just you, the installer, or the owner, the builder, just taking care of what we need to take care of as far as ICF, but also as far as the subs that come behind us, mainly our drywall, our stucco, siding, and to explain how best this works with any case scenario, any slab, any dimension, and any amount of corners, and how with the 1-inch module that we have here with BuildBlock, what we're capable of doing with the 1-inch module. As far as California type framing production, all long walls get the plates going long to long, and all the short walls, we cut them short and work them within the walls. So I have developed a system in the ICF to do the exact same thing. So we have long corners, we have short corners. So you want to come in down to a block and look at the long corner and the short corner. All ICF has a short corner and a long corner. And using that short corner or long corner into a common system, a plan, so that every job you go on and every installer that we teach is going to come in and is going to do it exact same way. He's going to already know how we're working. So when we're teaching installers, whether we have multiple jobs or one very big job, everybody knows the plan. So we're going to implement the plan, everything decently in order. We're going to develop a plan. So all the long corners, they're going to face each other on the long walls. All the short corners, they're going to face each other on the short corners. Okay. So as we have the mock-up set up here, we're going to call this our long wall. This long corners to our facing our right. This long corner is also facing our left. We're using our 8-inch core to do this mock-up wall, to do this demonstration. If I had a best case scenario, everything landed perfectly 6 inches on center. Now, the corners stagger. You don't pound on them, beat on them with your fist, because you'll bend the nubs. I'm going to come over here and set again the corner in the opposite direction. Pull in my next 4-foot standard. Now what I do most of the time, we put the block in this end first and we lay it back towards the other block. It seems a little backwards, but it actually fits best, goes in best, locks in best. Okay, so if this was best case scenario, we'll then take the next block and just lay it up against the existing hole. Draw my line where the cut needs to be made. Now on the BuildBlock, we have a tape measure already on the block. This ends up getting cut on 42 inches or at 42 inches. I will then roll over the block and I will do again the line so you can actually see where your cut's at. I'll actually cut my block here on the block itself. Use a typical 10-inch pruning saw. I like the longer one, they have shorter ones. This causes the least amount of trash. The teeth are actually cut to the inside, so they are very sharp, but they don't feather out, so they're not creating a lot more foam when you're making your cut, okay? So it's the least amount of trash you can cut when you're cutting the ICF. I like the 10-inch saw because you get good long strokes. It gives you a chance to make a very, very clean cut. Okay, very square, very straight. I'm going to take this block and fit into this opening. And bring this together. Now this is your best case scenario. And believe it or not, it does happen often. Notice that all your webs are lining up. Okay, it happened that I did this on purpose. I put an 18-inch piece in the bottom here, and then took a 48-inch piece, cut 6 inches off to bring in my special. I brought my special again from my right to my left within the last 4 foot for your drywaller. Typically your drywaller and most subs working right to left. And by working right to left, they're also going to bring their material down, and they're going to have their last bit of cuts here in the last 4 foot of wall. If there was a window or a door, you would make this special over a window and under a window or over a door, because you want the least amount of cuts when you're actually laying out your ICF. Okay? Now I'm going to go with the not so perfect layout. I've already cut the block, but I'm going to fit them in and show you what I did as we went about a layout that doesn't work exactly 6 inches on center, so you can end up with 1 6-inch piece. Now one of the things about 6-inch pieces, after you get a couple rows up, you've established your layout, because rows 1, 3, 5, and 7 are the same, and rows 2, 4, 6, and 8 are the same. I can take some 6-inch pieces and put them next to each other to put your waste right in the wall. Okay? Now you don't want to put a 6-inch piece to the point that two seams line straight up. You don't want to do that. You'll make sure they're not on the seams. And then you would come here. Actually, I'm going to move this over to show you. Here's a 6-inch piece. Here's a 6-inch piece. Then you take a 12-inch piece and go over your seam. And then you can keep going with 6-inch pieces again, or 18-inch piece, or 24-inch piece. You don't want to do this on a row that you're going to have your last row, because you want another row, full row, to go right over these 6-inch pieces. You want the seams to be locked back in again. But they don't, once the next row is on, I'm going to grab a piece and show you. Once the next row is on, that'll hold during concrete. So you definitely don't let the seams line up when you're putting in your 6-inch pieces, and make sure that they have a piece that's going to bridge that seam as if it was a full piece. My recommendation on your 6-inch pieces or your 12-inch pieces is in row 4 or row 5, just before your last row if you're only doing 6 rows, which is 8 feet. So now we're doing the not so perfect case scenario. Here's my measurement off my first row. Here's the piece that I have left. Okay. Now what I've already done, I've already positioned the ends, because let's say I'm thinking we're going to do stucco. I've already kicked the corners out just a hair, because when I just a minute ago, this was slightly in, it's not on a module. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to kick the two corners out, hang them about 1/8 of an inch off your slab, which is no big deal for your weep screed. It'll work just fine. So now I'm going to mark again where we're going to cut. Notice I don't have my tape measure out. It's been on my belt ever since we started. Okay, so you can do this and do your layout without ever pulling your tape measure out. Okay, so you can measure it if you want, but you don't need to. Again, the numbers are on the face of the block. This is at 16 inches. I'm going to bring this up. We're going to cut at 16 inches. Okay, so I'm going to fit this piece in. Okay, again, I've brought my cut out of the corner. pretty big standard we have. We do not cut the corners unless you have a door or a window within the corner. Your corners are your commodity. You don't want to cut the corners. You don't want to be short a corner. You can cut it straight, and you can put them together, glue them together, add more, you're okay. But if you're short on corners, one of the biggest rules of thumb you want to do is, or don't, is don't cut your corner. Okay, so I'm going to bring in the next piece. I've already cut these. We did a demonstration yesterday morning. I want to show you something. My last web right here, that's going to be my last full web. You're going to watch it line up. Here's also my other last web coming right to left and left to right. So when you have a special, whether it's over a door, under a window and over a door, here again, here's my last common web here. Coming in from that outside corner this way. Here's my last common web coming in from this out corner this way. These two guys are staggering. Ignore them. Your drywaller is going to ignore him. He's going to go for the one that's common going straight up. He's going to go for this one going straight up. These two, it doesn't matter. Now I'm going to show you with my tape and the modules. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have 6 modules tying this wall together. That's 6 inches. Okay, that's pretty standard. Notice I cut this way on this one and this way on that one to get an overlap. Your drywall is going to ignore it. Your stucco guy is going to ignore it because they're going to both come from this outside to the inside corner. Again, with no openings in your wall, you'll do this in your last 4 foot because that's where they're going to cut their drywall. It's pretty standard. They're pulling everything right to left. Obviously, we just have a little mock-up wall here. But in a house condition or a commercial condition, the longer the wall, the more speed they're going to get going right to left. Again, you want to save your drywall and save your subs and invite them into the scenario as far as working with insulated concrete forms and BuildBlock. BuildBlock has a 1-inch module. Because of that 1-inch module, when you're splitting the slab outside to outside, you're splitting the slab. That's half of what you're splitting it. Now that's what you're gonna have hanging over or hanging in. If you have stucco, you'll let that hang out. This is worst case scenario, because remember, you're splitting it from end to end, taking half the module and splitting it again. If it's gonna be siding, you're gonna bring it in and let it have the lip of the concrete stick out a little bit. You'll kick off your siding off your first row as you normally would instead of using a piece of lattice. That's the benefit of having the 1-inch module. And having the A crate, and as small as these are, some people say, what if concrete gets in there? You just put duct tape on it between your pores. But having this surface is a benefit for pouring and having that 6-inch lap, typically minimum 6-inch lap, as far as what you're going to have holding with the nubs coming off the top of your ICF. Now the BuildBlock ICF is fully reversible. The corners are fully reversible. The standards are fully reversible. Flip it either which way you want. It's got a tape measure on it, top and bottom. It has horizontal lines perforated every 4 inches, and it has a solid line in the middle that allows you to cut this block and flip this block for your top course, or you would cut a special row on your bottom course to figure out where your joists are gonna be if you're gonna do more than one floor, multi-floor, and especially if you're gonna do an insulated concrete deck like Build Deck. Some of the attributes as far as our block, we have an 1.5-inch wide web on our regular block. Our webs are 6 inches on center versus 8. That was a small change for me going from a 8-inch on center block in the past, and found that on my poor days, now are very comfortable. And notice we finished these walls, there was no plywood on it, okay? Ready for pour, needs rebar obviously, but as far as the block is concerned, we're ready for concrete, no plywood needed. So we want to thank you this morning for taking the time to review this and look at some industry standards that we've developed. And we look forward to being with you and for you with us on your next project.